So we're hearing that some of the provisions in the Biden administration's executive order and actions on climate change might affect the oil and gas industry here in New Mexico. Is the pause on some federal leases a blow to the state's industry?
I think it could be. And the reason I say it could be is because it depends. If you look at the pause right now and the immediacy of it, there probably is not a big impact. And part of that is because the pause right now is a pause on leases and a pause on new drilling applications, as I understand it. Right now, New Mexico has a number of drilling applications that were approved. And so in the short run, I don't think that there is going to be a tremendous impact. Longer term, depending upon what the pause ends up being and what the provisions are, it could certainly impact, especially, I think, the Permian Basin.
So is it realistic? One of the things I've heard is that the oil and gas industry will just move their operations to the Texas side of the border. Is that a realistic future?
Well, you know, oil is where you find it is one of the things I would say. And so certainly to the extent that they perhaps can move to the Texas side and they have places to drill and to produce, that could certainly be the case. I mean, one of the things about New Mexico is that there is a fairly high level of federal lands. And so I think that's one of the pieces that the oil and gas industry is worried about is the fact that there is a large amount of federal leasing. And so you could see if there is a change in the cost to produce oil on the New Mexico side, you could see some producers moving to Texas if it were more amenable to their production, or if it was lower cost. You could see them moving out of the Permian Basin if that was a better deal or a better outcome for them as well.
So New Mexico for a long time has been moving toward more renewable energy sources as a part of our electric grid, as a part of our electricity sources. As we talk more and more about having to diversify the state's economy, are these renewable jobs, are they equal to what the oil and gas industry has brought to the state's economy? What does the future look like with renewables in New Mexico?
I'm going to sound like an economist because I'm going to say it depends. And it depends on a lot of different things. If you look at a lot of the renewables, if you look at the renewable generation and just say, let's take a wind plant, a solar, a photovoltaic plant, a generation area, the basically building that has a number of jobs. After that, my understanding is that the operation requires much less. That certainly is not going to be a one-to-one. So anything that we would see in terms of job creation is going to have to be associated more, I think, with a new energy or renewable energy economy, where it may be building of equipment or it may be other areas. But if you're just looking at taking something where you either had someone working in a fossil fuel generation plant or in the oil and gas industry, that one is going to be a hard thing to say that, yes, we will have an equal number of jobs if we're just talking about new generation plants. I think that's maybe one of the reasons that you see in President Biden's climate initiative or climate plans, where they do talk quite a lot about, economic revitalization. They understand that there is going to be a gap in jobs. And so it just depends on what are those jobs going to be.
So one of the things that when we talk about the life of the oil and gas industry, we have to acknowledge the fact that the greenhouse gas emissions from that industry and consumption of oil and gas leads to climate change. There's a strain on water supplies, there are impacts on public health and the environment. How many years do you anticipate we have left of, so-called boom times of oil and gas in New Mexico?
I think, again, it depends on how well the industry, the state, and the federal government, quite frankly, work together. In my own opinion, I think one of the problems that we've seen over the history of oil and gas, not only in the state of New Mexico, but across a number of states in the United States, are that there's been a power struggle where we are a major contributor to the state revenues. And so we need to be protected. And it's now come to the forefront that, yes, there are great economic benefits to the oil and gas industry. But as you say, the climate change problem and the associated externalities with burning fossil fuels is a tremendous problem. And so, you know, to have a boom time, perhaps that boom time looks something different than what we have right now. Is there a way to continue to have fossil fuels, but to work towards reducing the greenhouse gas emissions? I think one of the problems is that we have, you know, this idea that maybe we can just go to this renewable energy future. Quite frankly, I don't see that smooth transition without having bridge fuels, without figuring out ways to incorporate the oil and gas industry into that, at least for some period into the future.
Do you have any sense of whether there's acknowledgement within the oil and gas industry that things are changing and that, you know, we're likely not to see the same future as the present?
You know, I think you can look to some of the firms. I think you can look to British Petroleum as an example. And one of the things that they've done in the last, I don't know, maybe 1 to 2 years, I would say, is they've reduced down their exploration staff. They've reduced that, from my understanding, at about 700 people worldwide down to about 100. And they are moving in different directions. So I think that's one of the things that we are seeing is those traditional oil and gas firms, especially some of the majors, are basically diversifying. They are moving into other areas. They're moving more into renewable energy as well. So I would say that, yes, they may not publicly acknowledge that, but I think a large number do see that there are changes on the horizon.
So we've focused a lot on the oil and gas provisions of the Biden climate change order. I'm curious if there's anything else in that executive order that sparked your interest as having implications for New Mexicans.
Well, staying with the oil and gas industry, one of the things that would be, I think, a great negative is one of the provisions of that is to reduce the subsidies to fossil fuels. And that can't be done by executive order because I believe it's codified in our tax code, in the federal tax code. That would certainly change the cost structure to the oil and gas industry. It would make it more expensive. It would make it more expensive across the board. But that would not be a positive for the oil and gas industry. I think that also has so many political implications and fights, probably on both sides of the aisle, that the chances of that happening or coming forward are probably fairly small. I think it's some of the general provisions in terms of perhaps, you know, as I said before, the economic revitalization of looking at areas that either have been fossil fuel dependent or in other ways would be impacted by a climate initiative would be one of the pieces. I think in general, though, we also have to look at the fact that the whole idea behind this climate change initiative really is that recognition that you have to look outside of just the private costs and benefits, if you will, or profits of the oil and gas industry or the fossil fuel industry. And you have to look at what the societal costs have been in terms of climate change. So certainly anything that would result in a slowdown or a reduction of emissions, which would improve the overall climate scenarios that we have going forward, would have to be a positive. I don't think we have to look any further than some of the extreme weather events that we've been seeing that many would argue are being exacerbated by climate change, is saying anything to reduce that would certainly have an impact on the state of New Mexico.
Right. Well, Dr. Chermak, thank you so much. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.